Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Let me show you how you can set an alarm in the Reminders app. So there's a new feature in the Reminders app on the iPhone that's going to make a lot of people really happy. In addition to being able to set a reminder and have a notification when the time comes, you can now also have an alarm on the iPhone go off. This acts just like an alarm in the Clock app, but it's not part of the Clock app at all. It's part of Reminders. The idea here is that if you have a very important thing in Reminders, you can make sure that you don't miss it. It's going to act like an alarm. It's going to keep going until you dismiss it. And it also has other features like snooze. So when you first use Reminders, starting with iOS 26.2, you should get a message about this new feature, and it should ask you if you want to enable it. If you miss that message, you can always go back into Settings, and then scroll down to Apps, and then go to Reminders and look for the option here to have alarms. Make sure that is turned on. Now, when you go to the Reminders app and go to create a new reminder, I'll do one specifically in this reminders list here. You can create the reminder as normal. I'll just create a test one here. And then you can either click on the calendar button there or the details button there, and you could set a date and time to get a notification about that reminder. But now there's the new feature here, Urgent. If you turn that on, of course, date and time automatically go on, but you can go back to them and change them, like say change the date, or you can change the time. Let me set this one to go off really soon, and then you could add your notes, URL, and other things about this reminder. Now you'll see the reminder set there, and it has this little symbol there showing you that there's an alarm associated with it. You can, of course, go back anytime you want into here and then change the details and turn off Urgent there to not have it sound the alarm, but only just do a normal notification. So now with the iPhone locked, maybe sitting on your desk or in your pocket, you will get an alarm that's very much like getting an alarm from the Clock app. It'll look like this. There you go. Notice the distinctive blue color there of the big snooze button to differentiate it between this and an alarm from the Clock app. Now, you can slide here to stop it like you can an alarm in the Clock app, or you can tap snooze to snooze. You'll see that reminder there, snoozed. It's got the snooze timer countdown and a reschedule button as well. But also underneath it, it has a little circle there that you could check to basically complete that item. Here's what happens if we tap the reschedule button there. You can see it takes you right back to a custom view of the date, time, and the urgent switch there for that reminder. If you find these videos valuable, consider joining the more than 2,000 others that support MACMOST through Patreon. You get exclusive content, course discounts, and more. You can read about it at macmost.com/Patreon. So I've reset this one to be 5 minutes later. But this time, I'm going to go into Settings. And back here under Reminders and Settings, there's another setting we can look at. And that's further down on the screen here. And it's Complete for Alarm. And if you turn this on, now, instead of getting the option to snooze, you just get the option to mark the item as complete. Now let's look at what happens when that option is turned off. So you can see here, now you just have a big complete button and slide to stop. If I tap complete, it will complete the item. But if I slide to stop like this, then you can see I go into this mode here and it just shows me when it was due. There's a reschedule button and I can still complete it here. Otherwise, I've just skipped the alarm at this point. It's not going to remind me again. So I think it's obvious what this is really for. It's for reminders that are very important, that cannot be missed. You don't want to rely on a simple notification to tell you that it's time to do something. But at the same time, you don't want to set an alarm. And remember, reminders can be set for any time in the future, whereas alarms really work on a weekly basis. You can set one for tomorrow morning, or you could set one for Tuesday and Thursday at a certain time, that kind of thing. A reminder can have a specific date way in the future with a specific time, and now you get something that's very much like an alarm, but for that specific thing. Reminders can also have a lot more information attached to them. There can be the title of the reminder, the notes for it, a URL, you can attach images. There's all sorts of different things that you can do with a reminder, and they're pretty easy to reuse as well. There's also repeating options too. It may be interesting for some people to have a repeating reminder with that urgent alarm also assigned to it. There's definitely overlap now between the clock app and its alarms and the reminders app and its alarms, but I think each has its distinct uses as well. Thanks for watching. Want to know about every new MACMOST video each week? Sign up for the absolutely free MACMOST email newsletter at MACMOST.com/newsletter.